So the copyright infringement case has been decided in the Marvin Gaye estate versus Robin Thicke and Pharrell Williams for them supposedly infringing on Got to Give It Up with Blurred Lines. You know, when people hear the two songs, they can hear the similarities. They know it's influenced by, and they know that the groove is exactly copied by. I mean, I'll play Blurred Lines here. You don't have to be a genius to realize that that groove and this groove are similar. It's copied by it. Of course it is. But the actual song with the lyrics and the melody are nothing alike. This sets a really bad precedent. This is very similar to the Led Zeppelin versus Spirit case, where they are influenced by it, but they are not copies. If you consider the copy the lyrics and melody, anybody can come out and say, oh, well, they copied the groove. Yes, this is similar. It's definitely taken from it. They were influenced by this. It's the same tempo, it's the same groove elements, but it's a different lyric and melody. All you need is for somebody, a lawyer, to come out and be willing to work for a percentage of the verdict and an uninformed jury, and you're going to get these kind of suits, and people are going to lose them. And I think this is a really terrible, slippery slope, even though they never should have copied it. They shouldn't have copied the groove. This is being influenced by a song, taking the elements of the groove and writing a completely different set of lyrics and melody. This is totally bogus. The judge should have thrown it out. And this is really bad for songwriters.